eat with attention. That means your 100% attention on the food and taste of the food, smell. You should enjoy your food. Now it is said by the famous chef that we first eat with our eyes. So that's why the one who is cooking the meal, they should try to make the food more appealing and more beautiful. Yes. Now come the sequence. There is a particular sequence one should follow while eating. Like the watery or easily digested food shall be consumed first, followed by the slow digesting food. Because what happened, in stomach we have whatever food you are taking, there is a concept of sequential dieting or sequential eating. Now this is your stomach. Whatever you will consume, that will make a layer, like whatever, like you have raw papaya first, so it will have a row of the first layer will be of raw papaya, that will digest it. Second, you consume salad, that will it will be get digested here. So the the process of digestion is in sequence, in layer wise. So what happens if you consume some like easily digestible food after a slow digestion, food which is taking longer time to stay in the stomach, like if you have meat first and then you are having fruits or raw salad, then what will happen, what happens is that the food which is having slow quick digestive property, they have to wait till that slow digesting food is leaving your stomach. So during that waiting period, whatever food, whether it is fruit or starch or cooked or raw vegetables, it start decomposing and it will lead to fermentation. And as you know, fermentation, it leads to formation of gas, and and ultimately it will lead to indigestion. So in like metro cities, we are seeing a lot of patients which are complaining of that poor digestion. So these are very very small things, but they have a very large impact on your digestive process. In one way, if you follow the diet in in a wrong sequence, you have the diet in the wrong sequence, you are really abusing your stomach, and your power of digestion is going to be a decrease in the long run. You will end up having a lot of digestive problems that leads to weight problems also. Now chew all food close to liquid. Now what happened, we are living in a very busy society, so we all try to finish the food as early as possible. Now this is bad, because what happened when you chew, masticate the food properly, the process of digestion start right inside the mouth. So you have to chew almost to the liquids. That means your stomach will be less burdened. So always try to chew your food properly, eat slowly. Avoid drinking beverages or even water during or after meals, because it will dilute the gastric juices which are secreted in the stomach and intestine. So try to follow this. Eat in generous amount and quit before satiety. Now many people, they eat till they satisfy that hunger. This is bad for the health. You should eat only 1/3 of your capacity of your stomach. 1/3 should be left for the water and 1/3 for the air. So if we will follow this, I don't think anybody will end up with any weight issues. We will all be very slim, and there won't be any food scarcity. Now what to eat? Nutritious, hygienic and well-cooked food. I think everybody here knows. Well balanced, that means it should have adequate calories, amount of carbs, proteins and fat. Now what is the difference between dietics in modern science? It is today we have nutritionists which advise you what to eat and what not to eat. because we are having so many lifestyle diseases. But Unani medicine, we give emphasis on the quality or the inherent temperament of that particular food, whether it is good, beneficial, or in compliance with your inherent temperament. Like in my earlier lecture, I have described you that we have four basic temperament, and each temperament has its own do's and don'ts. So diet plays a very important role in that. So we should consume the food which is in accordance with your temperament, your pepsis power. Now everybody is not blessed with good pepsis, that is good digestion power. Body status, season. For example, in cold weather, we should eat vegetables with slight bitter taste, like methi, soya, karela, bitter gourd, and such kind of vegetables which are having bitter taste. One type of food at a time and at proper time interval, that is 3 to 6 hours, 3 to 4 hours, or when previous food is completely digested. What happened, the interval of food is also not very well regulated, but 3 to 4 hours is the ideal time in a person whose digestive function is good. 4 hours every digestion process get completes if you are following the diet according to your pepsis power. Sweet food item. Now this is one of the ritual in Unani medicine, to have sweet food item in moderate amount after the meal, and as well as wine. Now wine is considered good for the health in moderation. Now you can see in newspapers every day some research going on, and it's confirmed that if you take wine in moderation, it is good for health. But later on, when this Unani medicine got inherited by the Middle East scholar, and as wine or any intoxicated beverages is prohibited in Islam, they abolished this. But still it is there in the books. There are many medicated wine, which that balsamic wine, or there are many different flavored wine which is taken according to one particular temperament, or sometimes the physician recommend to have a particular type of wine for a particular ailment. So wine also important. After meal? No, before. Now diet, these are the general guidelines for the a specific temperament people. Like diet for choleric, their pepsis is strong because there it's lot of heat in their body. So the indication are that type of food, they should have the food which are having cold temperament, such as sour taste food, citrus food, and green vegetables are good for the choleric people. And they should avoid fried and spicy food because they are heat generating. So it will give rise to more heat, and they will come up with acidity, hyperacidity, and that can lead to a number of problems in choleric temperament. Then comes diet for phlegmatic. The pepsis is slow and weak in these kind of people. They should have moderate amount of fat-free diet, because fat is also cold, so they should avoid fat. And contraindicated, they should avoid kasif, badi, sar food, milk and dairy products at night. A hakim prescription is considered incomplete without this particular advice on diet, because diet plays a very important role in recovery phase. It's a maintenance of health ke saath saath. When the body is suffering from any disease, and if you made or indulge in the wrong food choices, you may hamper the recovery phase of that particular illness. So one should be very cautious what type of diet he is having. Now we recommend the phlegmatic people not to have milk and dairy products at night. Why? Because these milk and dairy products tends to produce more phlegm in their body, and at night the temperature is less, so they should avoid it. Now kasif, badi, der hazm giza, these kind of food which are having, because their digestive process is already weak, so they are not able to digest properly the food which are going to take longer time for digestion. So they try to avoid it. Now, aloo gobi baigan, these kind of vegetables come under the food which should be avoided by the one who are having phlegmatic temperament. And if they will have it, they will come up with digestion, joint pains, then acidity and such kind of problems. Now, diet for melancholic, they again, their pepsis is slow and delicate. We recommend for them easily digested, that is called latif giza, producing good kinds such as fresh vegetable, fruits, especially they should have nuts, dry fruits and poultry items. They should not take dried fish and meat, it's bad for them. Now there are certain, I told you earlier, okay, if you have indigestible combination of food, you really going to abuse your stomach. So here are some of the wrong or harmful food combination, like sour food item with milk, fish with milk, which is very common, everybody knows, reddish with curd, very fine flour like maida and bakery products are bad for the health. Eating raw, fresh or dried food after cooked food, as I explained you, because it's not going to, it have to wait a longer period and it will ferment. And the last is, you should not store oil in copper utensil, because there is interaction, it can cause the oil will get contaminated by this mineral. So these are certain things we should follow. Now there are certain etiquettes which should be followed, which are called as healthy eating. Now washing hands before meals, and the research has also proved that if you are eating the food with hands, it's really helps the food to get digest smoothly as compared to the spoon. And second, the food which is eaten with spoon can never be as tastier as eaten with your own hands. So the Indian habits of eating the food with hands is really, really good and scientific and good for the body. Eating in relaxed sitting position. Now many of the people in buffet, they eat while standing. So it's not a good posture for eating. Eating should be in